I just rode my bike 55 minutes, 11.43 miles, and today's that date. I had to go to UPS and drop off a package for return. There I am. This is not ideal, so let me put this down. It is freaking hot today. We're having a heat wave. So, my first initial impression, and also when I woke up this morning, I had no air on this. So I had to, because I just converted this recently, 2 days ago. This one I already converted to tubeless for over 10 days. And this one I wanted to wait till I got the hub all situated, the wheels all situated before I converted it. But I woke up this morning and I think what happened is that everything else is sealed really well because I did the soapy bubbles in water and nothing was bubbling. So the only thing I could think of is I didn't seat this inside the rim snug. And I forgot to take the O-ring, so there is an actual base seal of a rubber seal on the bottom of this tubeless valve, Presta valve, and then there's also an O-ring that I needed to take out and put it against the rim. And then with this model, it comes with that little rubber too. I don't know if you guys could see that. Anyway, I'm using double nut on this because I find that it holds the valve against the rim better. So that's my little hack. And I do the same thing on this side. Where is it? Where are you? There. Okay. I love this hub because I've been riding for 10 days on my old wheel with that old XD hub, and because I'm not able to use that, I had to go use this wheel. And after using that with the hub engagement being much better than this, and then all of a sudden I'm riding on this, it made a huge difference with my power transfer on the pedal. See how quick that moves? Usually there's a delay with this one. So I felt faster because I did a loop from here in the house. I went down and dropped off the Amazon package at the UPS store, and I decided to do a nice big 11-mile loop. And I went on the road and off the road, and everything felt good. I felt like I was just powering on the hills, and there was no slippage. And that is the biggest thing I noticed. So to the company, JGBike, my initial impression, you guys did a great job. Please keep your hubs affordable for people like me that can't afford $500 hub. And I am grateful to you guys and gals, whoever is running this company, that you have introduced this to the cycling community. And I really appreciate that. Based on today's initial ride, I am going to buy another set of the hub that I got from Amazon, exactly the same thing. And also, PS to JGBike, because I know I've been communicating with them. The shim for this cassette, an 11-speed XD cassette, works fine without the shim or the 1.85 millimeter spacer. So the shifting on this, I didn't change anything. I didn't do any alignment. It's the same thing. I didn't touch it. I didn't change the cable tension, nothing. And it's shifting beautifully without the shim. And so my initial impression, JGBike, thank you for having this wonderful product for people like us. And we appreciate it. And make sure you keep it affordable, please.